Ball free and brings up third down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play.
Now the pressure comes, and he goes down just inside the 10, back at the 9. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. He'll take it at the 42. They run, it's Oliver. And he's going to be stopped at about the 37. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They'll come out in the pistol. To throw, it's Manning. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. With touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Giants are going to take a first quarter lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
The kicking team out there for the Giants as they will send this one away. And the mile high air in full effect as that's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And Denver getting set to take the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up 2nd and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
A dump off to Anderson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field. Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
On 2nd down, Anderson. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up 3rd.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat.
Anderson loses the football. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Manning to throw on 2nd down. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
one thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you go lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Well, that's the kickstarter right there. Eli Manning finding his guy, Odell Beckham Jr.
Yeah, it's a deadly combination, isn't it?
It really is, but what really makes it work is just how unflappable Eli is with his demeanor, able to maintain his calm and his poise. Because we know, OBJ, he can run pretty hot and get excited out there.
Sometimes just one-handed grabs for him.
It doesn't matter what it is. Just throw it up there, he'll go get it. And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way, and really we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
They run it here with Oliver. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal. The defense came out with a look that they had prepped for all week to attack. They took advantage, got the first down.
And the key words in there, prep for all week. They really studied them, understood their tendencies, knew what they liked to do, and prepared their game plan accordingly. And boy, the payoff was good.
Only 2 yards on the completion at second down. They'll send Beckham alone to the left side. Now Manning throwing on second down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's the Giants with a football here as we begin quarter number two. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Manning now on third and goal. That's caught at the 2. Give him 3 on the play. And that will bring up an interesting decision here on 4th and goal.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet. Get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Manning indeed going for blitz coming, and down he goes. Von Miller, he's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. And Denver getting set to take the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Yeah, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
Following the penalty, Anderson, and he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. Three yards remaining here on second down. A fake to Anderson, now it's Lynch. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. A big play that time on the catch and run. And the Broncos are going to have a new set of downs.
They hit that crossing route really well. Excellent timing. Puts it right on him, and he keeps running.
Yeah, turned it upfield for good yardage. They'll come out in the pistol.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
They go play action here on first down. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. A gain of 6 there on first. That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it, because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through. all that traffic, and people want to put a little contact on it. Really well done.
They run Anderson, and he'll go down at the 28. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
So much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice gain. The defense had felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. 10th carry now for Anderson. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 5. Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5.
Detroit!
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. Thomas, the lone receiver, left. Lynch now throwing on 3rd. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Rolando McClain in there to get him for a loss of 9, and that'll lead to 4th down.
Probably a little bit of a surprise call there on 3rd and inches that they decided to throw the football. And how difficult is that for an offensive line when they look up and see all those extra bodies coming at them?
Tons of bodies coming in. They get a huge sack there. So this offensive unit, they've now had 3 drives, and they only have 3 points to show for them.
Payoff is the key for everything. How many offenses have we talked to that say we have to finish drives? Thus far, this team hasn't finished it quite the way they wanted to.
Here's the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. And last time, they had it 4th and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind and try to put together another drive.
Hey, a simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow him to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. Over the middle to Beckham. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. So holding by the offense, and maybe now got to shift up what you want to do on the playbook.
Yeah, definitely. Change what you're doing in the playbook, but boy, the advantage shifts to the guys on defense, doesn't it? Longer yardage situations, they often become bolder.
Manning the throw on 2nd down to Shepard, complete over the middle. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver.
He's got a man complete. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Eli to OBJ. What a combo. And really, how do you defend them when they're on their game?
Absolutely, and they're on their game in this one. That's really what this offense is predicated on, isn't it?
It really is. It's explosive plays, and it doesn't matter whether Eli throws it 3 yards or 30 yards. OBJ can provide that.
Now Manning again. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
And the Broncos go to a nickel set on 3rd down.
Yeah, they've got an extra DB out there. To throw, it's Manning. And he's got his man, Denell. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. And the offense lining up 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Good, 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 good.
Manning to throw on second down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 1:59 to go in the first half. Back to Denver right after this. A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, partner. It's caught, Shepard. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. And quickly, they get to the line. Working from the gun, Manning. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Brandon Oliver with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Giants add on to their lead. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. This one taken from the 7. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Broncos offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. On second down, Lynch. A dump off to Anderson. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They'll throw on first down with Lynch. He's going to wind up and air it out. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. From midfield now, here's Lynch. And he will have a man, Demaryius Thomas. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. One receiver left, 3 to the right. On 1st and 10, it's Lynch. Looking left side and completing it to Thomas. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. In the backfield is Anderson. Throwing here, Lynch on 1st down. And he'll go right back to Thomas, complete again. And down inside the 15 he goes. And now the Giants, they get the officials' attention and take another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. Thomas, the lone receiver left. Now it's Lynch. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. On 2nd down, here's Lynch. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On 3rd down, Lynch can't find anyone open. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Janoris Jenkins.
Brandon, And this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
So after the INT, it's Manning over the middle here to Donnell. So we reach halftime here, and it's him.
So this guy's just sitting there, right? He's got like 30 hot dogs in front of him. And what's that? Apparently we're back. Okay, so Larry's halftime show got cut off. Sorry, we were doing story time here in the booth. We are ready, though, for the third quarter.
Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for him. He's got time in the pocket. And Ty Montgomery has it complete. That catch good for five. It's third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Fake to Anderson, now it's Lynch. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Oh, free safety blitz, that can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass. And when he comes at the quarterback, he better get home and make the play. Otherwise, a big play could result for the offense.
He'll take it a few steps in front of the 50. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Giants will begin this drive in good shape, first and 10. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done. The insistence of speed at every position is really seen at the defensive end spot. These guys in old days were often outside linebackers. They just pushed them forward because they wanted to play fast and get to the quarterback or the running backs quicker than ever before.
They get 14 yards there and a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Here's Perkins on first down. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
So third and five, third and medium here. They'll send Beckham alone to the left side. From the gun on third down, Manning. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Derek Wolfe in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. And they weren't in zone coverage, they were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down. distance was never an issue, not in this Mile High Air. But it doesn't matter what elevation you're at if you don't put it on target. And this one kind of takes off on him.
Now Lynch. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was looking for Ty Montgomery that time. And it's second down.
Timing is crucial in any route thrown. But when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
Now Lynch to throw. Caught by Montgomery. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
They come out here in the eye. They'll run it. Here's Anderson. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a fourth down. A well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the five. They'll spot it at the six-yard line. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field. Attempt for him.
Manning gonna give it to Perkins. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Over the middle to Beckham. The reception good for seven. It's third down. So deja vu all over again. Another good week. And sometimes maybe because the defense doesn't look that bad, maybe this is just good offense beating good defense in his case.
I like that because we always want to point out that there's a breakdown or someone made a mistake or there was an error. Sometimes it's exactly as you described it. Sometimes they just made better plays. And that's what he's been doing for the last 2 weeks. Someone's got to find a way to cover this guy. Otherwise, he may set some records.
Manning now on first down. The left side throw complete to Adams. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Caught on the right side by Adams. And he's going to be taken down deep into Bronco territory. It's a big-time play there for the G-Men. 44 yards. And the numbers, they sort of do the talking. Great game last week. Sharp again here in this one.
Sometimes you set habits with how you play, don't you? I mean, you start to put things together, you string them together, and the confidence continues to rise. And guess what? We're seeing that happen.
Back now at the home of the champs, Sports Authority Field in Denver. It's the Giants with the football and also the lead as we get set to start quarter number four. Offense walks to the line for play number seven of the drive. Again, they'll throw with Manning. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Well, they try to swing it on left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Manning to throw once more. This will be caught at about the 5. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
So third and goal, the defense in the dime.
Can still bring pressure.
And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Giants are able to grow their lead. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score.
Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Janoris Jenkins. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
So after the INT, it's Manning. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Here's a carry for Oliver. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They come out here in the eye. First and goal, Perkins. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Paul Perkins, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And thanks to the interception, the Giants offense cashes in with 6. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. But he will not be able to bring this one back in the extra point attempt. Unsuccessful.
I remember when they changed the rule. And there's a lot of consternation, especially coming from the kickers. Okay, how's this going to affect things, having to kick a longer one now, much more of a field goal attempt? And the defensive guys saw it as an opportunity to get more block.
That's exactly right. There's more effort now. Before, when it was snapped down near the goal line, you would basically see guys just stand there.
Yeah, not anymore. Now, those guys are going after it because not only can they knock it away and change a little bit of momentum,
and get 2 points,
they can pick it up and take it back for 2 points.
They start the drive with Anderson. And he powers his way up past the 30. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. B.J. Goodson not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. Big sack on 2nd down. Now the offense needs to convert here on 3rd.
Hurry up. Here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
Now Paxton Lynch on 3rd and long. Screen play. Anderson. 5 yards on the screen, but that'll take us to 4th down.
I want
wonder what was going through his mind when he got the play call. He just got sacked on the previous play. He knows they're coming after him again. A little bit of guts to stand in there, take the hit, and successfully complete the screen pass. Really well done.
And now a high kick here as they'll try to cover this one. Fielded just inside the 20. 51 yards on the punt there. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. And New York set to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back. And oh, he coughed it up. It's picked up by the Broncos. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory.
In today's NFL, most teams don't have as many goals for the game like we used to have where you checked off your boxes. But zero turnovers, that's a universal. And while it won't likely cost them in this game, they're going to regret the fact that they coughed one up here.
Yeah, their first blemish. They had mistake-free football prior. And he showcased the spin but couldn't do much else as he's wrangled down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slides.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jason Pierre-Paul in there to get him, and that's sack number 12 for him on the year. And the defense will try and pin their ears back and get pressure again here after the sack. It's third down. Throwing, Lynch. A dump off to Anderson. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Call it a three-yard gain, and it'll be fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. Here we go, Lynch on fourth down. Finds his target, Montgomery. Give him 14 on the play. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. And that's what you've got your tough little slot receiver for, isn't it? Right there, those fourth down conversions in the middle of the field.
He knows that's where he has to make his living, and that's where he has to make plays to help his team. And no one is asking him to do anything more or less than do exactly what we saw there.
Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Once again, it's Lynch. Caught by Montgomery. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Third down and 3. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now it's Lynch. And that is incomplete. Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver. And now it's fourth down.
It appears that the pressure is affecting him today. Normally, he knows exactly when to get rid of the football. But today, because he's been hit a few times, he's getting rid of it a little bit too quickly.
And McManus able to put it through. And that'll get this back down to a 20-point spread. Well, in the grand scheme of things, it's likely not going to matter much, but at least they get themselves 3 points closer to respectability.
And I don't know that they're going to feel a whole lot better about things because they've clearly been outplayed all game long. But hey, no reason not to take the points when the opportunity presents itself.
Now they're down big here on the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort, at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
And
New York set to take the field. They have the big cushion. Here in the final stages of this one, I don't know if there's any better feeling than being up big on the road.
There really can't be, because for a team...
And down he goes! A sack. They sack him back across midfield at about the 48-yard line. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
And now they're in the hurry-up. Throwing is Manning on third down. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Brad Wing now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half.
I feel like you and I could be in our backyard with our dads right now. What did they always say when they were throwing us the ball? Look it all the way in. Make sure you secure it. That had the feeling of not happening there on that play, that he didn't have full control of the ball.
When that punt's coming in, I have a return punt, but I would imagine it's tough to monitor those guys coming full steam ahead at.
It really is. You try and get that peak to know where they are about whether you should fair catch it or not, but sometimes you just have to have a sense, a feeling, and just have to make sure, number one, though, you catch the ball and put it away.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. From the gun on third down, Manning, he finds Beckham complete. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Manning, and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. Manning looking to throw it. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Manning. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. I guess not content to get another three here late. They'll try to add 6 more as they go on fourth and goal. They'll try and run for it with Oliver.